Let us see the chapter logarithms. Let us define it first. Let a be a real number such that a is greater than 0 and a is not equal to 1. And let b be a rational number such that a to the power b equals x. Then b is called the logarithm of x to the base a, which is written as log x with a base of a. Thus, a to the power b equals x. That implies b equals log x with a base of a. Here a to the power b is called the exponential form, and log x with a base of a is called the logarithmic form. Now let us start the exercise. Exercise 7A.
So students, let us see the first question of the exercise logarithm. The first question is convert each of the following to logarithmic form. So here as you can see, it's given in the exponential form, and we have to convert this into log form, logarithmic form. So let us see the first one. 5 to the power 2 is equal to 25. This is what given. We have to convert this into log form. So how we need to write? Log. Whatever is the answer here, that is 25, to the base, whatever was the base here, 5. And this equals to the power, that is exponent 2. Okay, I have already explained. So this is how we need. Log 25 to the base of 5 is equal to 2. So now second, 3 to the power minus 3 is equal to 1 by 27 is the same thing. Log 1 by 27, because this is a fraction, better we put in bracket, with a base of 3, this base will become the base. Please write carefully, the base should be in the base case, this should be in line, and equals whatever is the power, that is minus 3. Let us see the third bit. The third bit we had, 64 to the power 1 by 3 is equal to 4, so it becomes log, okay, 4 with a base of 64, you can write it down here, equals whatever is the power, that is 1 by 3. Okay, so this is how we convert the exponential form into logarithmic form. Let us see the second number. Question number 2 of exercise 7A. One we have already done. This is question number 2. It's asked to convert each of the following to exponential form. So here logarithmic form is given, and we have to convert it into exponential form. In question number 1, exponential form was given and we converted it into log form. This is opposite of it. Okay? Here log is given, we have to convert it into exponential. So have like this first one. Log 81 with a base of 3 is equal to 4, so this can be written as 3 to the power 4 equal to 81. Very easy, base will be base. This becomes the power and 81 comes here. Log 1 by 8 with a base of 3 is equal to minus 3. So it becomes 2 to the power minus 3 is equal to 1 by 8. 2 to the power minus 3 is equal to 1 by 8. Simple, just have a look carefully, you'll understand. Similarly here, what's the base? Write the base first, 10. And equal to whatever is given, that will become the power 10 to the power minus 2 equals whatever log we have found. So this is how we do it. Okay? This fourth bit. The rest bit you can try. Have a practice of it. You'll come to know. Log to exponential, exponential to log. It's very important. Okay? Now question number 3. By converting to exponential form, find the value of each of the following. We have to find the value of log 64 with a base of 2. But how do we have to find the value? You know, 2 to the power, how much is 64? 6. Is it? So the answer will come 6. 2 to the power 6 equal to 64. The value of log 64 with a base of 2 is 6. But we don't have to write directly, okay? We have to convert into exponential form and then find the value. Actually, this is an easy one given. If you are asked these and all, okay, we'll have to do in the process. So let us see. It's asked to convert into exponential form and then find the value. So let us see how to find. First, we'll take first bit. Now we'll convert this into exponential form as we did in question number 2. So the exponential form is if you convert this into exponential form, it becomes 2 to the power x equal to 64. The base origin is base 2, the power is x equal to 64. Okay, now see, think about it. 2 to the power x equal to 64, let us find the factors of 64. Prime factors. 64's factor is 0.2.
we have done so in the exponential 9 is 3 to the power 2, power to the power gets multiplied.
find the factors of 243, the prime factors of 243. If you find the factors, you see, this is 43, 3. Okay, 8 is 24, 3 1 is 3. 3 2 is 6, 7 is 21, 3 9 is 27, 3 3 is 9. How many 3s? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you write here, 3 to the power 5. Of course, I think it's lower. The factor of 243 is equal to 5. Now, neglecting this in the same way, neglecting base, both sides. So 2x is equal to 5, or the value of x is 5 by 2. Okay, so this is how we do. Now, let us see the third degree of separation. It's written log x minus 1 with a base of root 3 is equal to 2. Let us exponential form first of all. Square root of 2. Base is written first. Square root of 2. Oh, sorry. Cube root square root of 3 to the power 2 is equal to x minus 1. Now, what's the square of root 3? Square of root 3 is 3. 3 is equal to x minus 1. Bring this minus 1 to this side. 3 plus 1 is equal to x. What we get as value of x is? Okay. Now try the next question. Okay. One more I'll do. So now let us see question number 7. Okay. 7 qubits, sorry. 4 7 qubits. Let us see the solution. Log x square minus 9 with a base of 3 equal to 4. You have to find the value of x. Okay, 2 to the power 4 equal to this, or if you want to even write this also. Okay, x square minus 9 is equal to 2 to the power 4. Don't get confused, if you have practiced, we can do like this. 2 to the power 4 is equal to this, or x square minus 1 is equal to 2 to the power 4. It's the same thing. So x square minus 9 equal to 2 to the power 4 is 16. X square is equal to 16 plus 9. When the minus 9 goes to the side. X square is equal to 25, okay? Or x is equal to square root of 25. Square root of 25, you can write 5. Okay, so this is the solution for the value of x by converting into exponential form. Now let us see this. This also you have to convert into exponential form in the same way. Wherever we have x in the question, I am taking that first. So here I take x to the power minus 3 is equal to 0.008. Okay, x to the power minus 3 equal to 0.008. Now, x to the power minus 3 equal to 0.008 is 8 by 1000. Okay, cancel this if you want. If you cancel by 2, if you want to cancel by 4, if you want to cancel, it's up to you. By 8, that if you want to cancel, it's up to you. Okay, like by 8. 8 1 is 8, 2 left, 8 2 is 16, 8 5 is 14. So it comes 1 by 125. And 1 by 125 means 1 by 5 to the power 3. 1 by 5 to the power 3 is 5 to the power minus 3. So you can see that the powers are equal here. If the powers are equal, then the base are equal. I have already told you the indices chapter. So that implies the value of x is 5. We have neglected, okay? Neglected the powers here. Neglected powers. So x equal to 5. Value of x is 5. So this is how we do. Okay, let us see the last one. So now let us see question number 6. Fine, you can try yourself after this is done. Okay. So it's given log x with a base of 10 is equal to a, log y with a base of 10 is equal to b. First bit, it's asked to write down 10 to the power a plus 1 in terms of x. So let us see how to do. It's easy actually. Solution. First from the given thing, log base 10 x is equal to a. So you can write this in the exponential form as 10 to the power a is equal to x. So the value of 10 to the power a is x. Now you are asked to find 10 to the power a plus 1. Okay. Now how do you find this 10 to the power a plus 1? First let us convert both of them. Okay. I have converted the first one in the form of 10 to the power a equal to x. Now I will convert this also. Log y with the base of 10 is equal to b. So 10 to the power b is equal to y. So I have converted both of them in the form of 10 to the power a is equal to and 10 to the power b is equal to. Now first we have 10 to the power a plus 1. Okay. We are finding 10 to the power a plus 1. 10 to the power a plus 1 means 10 to the power a into 10 to the power 1. Come on. Remember the integers 10 to the power a into 10 to the power 1, power 1 gets added. So we are splitting this. Instead of 10 to the power a plus 1, I am writing 10 to the power a into 10 to the power 1. The value of 10 to the power a is known to us x. X into 10 to the power 1 means 10. So this is 10x. This is it. 10 to the power a plus 1 means 10 to the power a into 10 to the power 1. The value of 10 to the power a has been already found x, and this is 10. 10x. Let us see this. Second bit. You are asked to find the value of 10 to the power 2b. Now 10 to the power 2b. We have the value of 10 to the power b. So we'll write this as 10 to the power b square. Because you know power power gets multiplied. So 10 to the power b square 2b. The value of 10 to the power b is y. So this becomes y, and already 2 is there, so y square. So this is how we do second bit. Now third bit. Third bit is written if log p with the base of 10 is equal to 2a minus p. You have to express p in terms of x and y. Same way. First of all, the log form which is given, log p with the base of 10 is equal to 2a minus p. Let us convert this into exponential form. 10 to the power 2a minus b is equal to p. We can write this as 10 to the power 2a by 10 to the power b, because if it's minus, that means it's divide, as we have done earlier. When plus is there, into. Similarly, when minus is there, divide. So is equal to p. Now the value of 10 to the power 2a is not known to us, but the value of 10 to the power a is known to us. Doesn't matter. We'll write this as 10 to the power a square by 10 to the power b is equal to p. 10 to the power a value is known to us, that is x. So it becomes x square by 10 to the power b value is y. X square by y is equal to p, or p is equal to x square by y. That is what asked in the question. Express p in terms of x and y. We have got p in terms of x and y. Okay, p is equal to x square by y. Now we'll do the second exercise. You can practice the examples. See these questions. Try to practice the examples. The more you practice, the better you will be able to. Okay, then we'll see exercise 7.